Good morning, everyone, and welcome. I want to welcome little George. We're so happy that you brought your family here today, and we get to watch you be baptized. We're delighted you are all with us on this beautiful spring day, right? Spring is here. We're not going to let it go. It's here. I'm excited about that, too. Our opening hymn today is in the hymnals. We have those before you. It's number 455. If you would please stand and join in singing. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Pour your grace into our hearts, O Lord, that we who have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, announced by an angel to the Virgin Mary, may, by his cross and passion, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Exultare.
It is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sins. Consequently, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifices and offerings you have not desired, but a body you have prepared for me. And burnt offerings and sin offerings take no pleasure." Then I said, "See, God, I have come to do your will, O God. In the scroll of the book, it is written of me." When he said above, "You have neither desired nor taken pleasure in sacrifices and offerings and burnt offerings and sin offerings, these are offered according to the law," then he added, "See, I have come to do your will." He abolishes the first in order to establish the second. And it is by God's will that we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
please stand for the reading of the gospel?
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who is said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please pray with me. Lord, take me where you want me to go. Let me meet who you want me to meet. Tell me what you want me to say, and please keep me out of your way. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Angels, angels. What image comes to your mind when you hear that word? Is it those fat-cheeked cherubs with impossibly tiny wings that we see in Renaissance paintings? Or is it a larger-than-life human with huge white feathered wings behind them, something like what you'd see on a great white swan? These images abound. I don't know if you remember, but in the 90s, there was a resurgent of angel imagery. They were everywhere, all of a sudden, right? I don't know about you, but I had one of those cherubs that was sitting on a bookshelf with his little ankles crossed and his big wings behind him. We all did. They were everywhere. They were candle holders. They were everything you could imagine. It was so cute. But really, they were nothing new. Angels are as old as time, and they've been with us as long as men and women were artists. And they're not mythical creatures. There are many mentions of angels throughout the Old and the New Testament. The word angel is the name of their office, not of their nature. They are spiritual beings with appropriate missions and activities assigned to them by God. The Bible describes the function of angels as messengers, but does not indicate when the creation of angels occurred. Now, angels attended Jesus when he was tempted in the desert. Angels were in the empty tomb when the disciples ran there after Mary Magdalene told them that Jesus' body was missing. Angels walked in the streets of Sodom and were protected by Lot in the Old Testament. For all their importance, only a very few of them are named. Perhaps you remember the angel Raphael or the angel Michael, who also had the title of archangel. Apparently, the angel that was closest to God. And above all angels, the colonel of angels, if you will. And today, we have what may be the most famous of all angels to us, Gabriel. Gabriel comes to see Mary with an incredibly important message. And this moment has forever since been celebrated as the Annunciation. The moment Gabriel tells Mary that she is the most favored of God and will carry the Christ child. This moment is honored every year in the church calendar for many reasons. The name Gabriel means God is my strength. And he was indeed a messenger of great news. And this wasn't his first birth announcement, if you will. You see, he told Zechariah that he and Elizabeth, Mary's cousin, would have a child who would grow up to be John the Baptist. Pretty important news entrusted to this angel indeed. And just what shocking news did he tell? First, he tells the past their prime, Zechariah and Elizabeth, that they'd have a baby. Now let me give you some context. When the average person died in their late 40s in Jesus' time, if they hadn't had a child by the time they were 30, they were past their prime. So they're not 60 or 70 or 80 having a baby. They might be in their early 40s. And then he comes in to share this really improbable news with Mary. The artwork, all the stained glass windows you see, all of them, they present Mary as this mature young lady. Even the image that's on your bulletin right now makes Mary look like a young lady in her 20s, right? But that's not the case. What did Gabriel see when he looked at Mary? He saw a teenager, maybe 15, 16 at the most. He saw a very poor young woman from a backwater town with no family to speak of. Her unmarried pregnancy would have been an utter disaster for her in that moment. She is betrothed to another man. She's going to lose that, but she could lose more. She could be cast out by what family she has, and she could be led to the town square where she would be stoned to death. This was not a good announcement for Mary. Now, I want to take a moment to note that the author of this gospel lesson, Luke, was a learned physician, but he was not one of the original 12 disciples, though he did come soon after them. As a doctor, he knew exactly where babies came from, and he knew what time it took to give birth. But he also knew that God was capable of the impossible. He is likely to have interviewed Mary in her old age before he wrote his gospel. He betrays Mary as a model disciple, the servant of the Lord who responds in faith to the divine initiative to carry the Christ child. She no doubt told Luke about her visit from the angel Gabriel and her reaction to him and how she asked questions of this angel. Asking questions, you see, is not actually in and of itself a mark of unbelief. Mary had a questioning faith. She was eager to learn and understand what God wanted of her. Luke presents her as a model of discipleship, questions and all. My friends, you may think your ability, experience, or education make you an unlikely candidate for God's service, just like Mary must have in that moment that the angel spoke to her. But don't limit God's choices. I believe angels are still at work today. There goes one right now. Bringing messages to each and every one of us from God, calling us into His service. So today, on this Annunciation Sunday, I invite you to pause quietly for a moment while we gather for the baptism. And I want you to listen to that quiet voice being sent to you from God with a message just for you. Because I can promise you, one is being sent to you. And I want you to prayerfully consider it and respond as Mary did, with faith and willingness. Amen. Amen. Now I'd like to invite George and his godparents and his parents to come up with me. Bring your bulletins. Our service continues on page 5 in your bulletin. You can remain seated at this time. Your guys are going to be responsible for joy. So everywhere that we see, like down here, that's what you're saying. Okay? Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, by our baptism into the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, you turn us from the old life of sin. Grant that we, being reborn to new life in him, may live in righteousness and holiness all our days through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented.
I present George Hedge-Dramus to receive the sacrament of holy baptism.
Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life?
I will, with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
Let us join with those who commit themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. If you would all please stand as you are able. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He descended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of the bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it, your Son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who here are cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
George Head, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon this servant the forgiveness of sin, and have raised him into the new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works.
Amen.
George Head, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen. Amen.
Now let us welcome the newly baptized.
We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood.
Now let us say together the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in
accordance with the scriptures. He is ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That the life of Christ may be revealed in us.
We remember those who have died.
Father, into your hands we commend them.
We praise you for all your saints who have entered into eternal glory.
May we also come to share your heavenly kingdom.
Have compassion on those who suffer from sickness, grief, or trouble.
In your presence may they find strength.
Look with your kindness on our homes and families.
Grant that your love may grow in our hearts.
Make us alive to the needs of our community.
Help us to share one another's joys and burdens.
For the swift end to the war in Ukraine.
Lord, have mercy.
Inspire and lead those who hold authority in the nations of the world.
Guide us and all people in the way of justice and peace.
Strengthen all who minister in Christ's name.
Give us courage to proclaim your gospel.
We pray in silence for our own needs.
May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please, everyone, peace. I don't really want to. He is too wonderful. Too wonderful.
You good boy, this is your church. Yes, it is. You know where you're at.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I'm not sure he's going back to you.
I know.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Please, everyone, be seated. I joked with Nicole back in the sacristy earlier that the announcements were going to be longer today than my sermon, and that's kind of true. We've got so much going on. Today is the final day, our final Celtic service for Lent at 5 o'clock today. If you haven't been, you've got one more chance. It's a beautiful, quiet, meditative service. We have special music at it. It's at 5 o'clock. It lasts about 30 minutes. I hope that you'll consider coming and being a part of that. On the very back page of your bulletin shows all that we have going on during Holy Week. And Holy Week begins next Sunday, Palm Sunday. And I want to say something about that. So many people will skip over Palm Sunday and they get involved in the other services that happen during that week. That's like missing the first episode of a very important miniseries. Palm Sunday is critical to the understanding of just all of the things that go on with Maundy Thursday and Good Friday and Easter. So I commend it to you to come on Sunday this coming week as we experience the triumphant entry of Christ into Jerusalem just days before his crucifixion. So I hope that you can be here for that. Speaking of Easter, inside is your bulletin is an insert for our flowers. You all know that every year, year after year, Abby Fleming outdoes herself with a beautiful floral display on Easter Sunday here at the church. And that's not part of our budget. This is an opportunity for you to contribute with that, to that. by listing someone that you want to remember or someone that you are thankful for. And it could be your anniversary, it could be your grandchildren, it could be someone's birthday, or remembering your parents that may have passed. If you'll fill this out and put it in the offering plate today, you can bring a check by, just let us know that you're going to do it, or mail it, or bring it in no later than next Sunday for sure. So if you'll let us know about that, that'd be great. Easter Vigil, I've been talking about this like crazy. You know, we're joining up with Christ Church on Saturday, April 8th, over there in Sag Harbor, where we will have musicians and members from our choir with a special, that's the right day, right? Did I say the wrong date? No? It's the right day, okay. So we'll be there, we'll be participating in that with that congregation. It's an amazing service. It's not been a part of our tradition here at St. Anne's in the past. However, it's always been a part of my ministry and couldn't do it during COVID, but now we can do it. So I hope that you will put that on your calendar. And I love the fact that two congregations are going to be celebrating and worshiping together. Coffee hour, of course, will be following right after this. Sign up for what?
Easter breakfast,
thank you. On Easter Sunday, our times shift, 9 and 11, with coffee hour in between. Our choir will be singing at both services. They're very hungry in between the services, right? We must feed our choir and ourselves. So it'll be a wonderful potluck that day on Easter Sunday. Right after the 9 o'clock worship service, we're having coffee hour today, right after this. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself as an offering and sacrifice to God. What? You're pointing. Yes, Jenna.
278.
278. Thank you. There, in your bulletin on page 11, the offertory hymn is missing the last bar of music. So what I'm going to suggest is instead of reading and singing with it here on page 11, if you'll pull out your hymnals now and you can sing 278 with the choir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gracious God, we thank you for the bounty found in our blessing box wagon today, and for the fact that this will feed people who do not have enough food on their own this week. I ask that you will bless this food to their nutrition, and I ask that you will inspire people in the coming week to remember to bring food to add to this collection next Sunday. All this in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. This is the Lord's table, and everyone is welcome to receive communion from it. However, if you would prefer to come to the rail for a blessing, just cross your arms like this, and I will be happy to give you one. I have gluten-free wafers. Just let me know if you need one when you're at the rail. And as has been our custom since COVID descended on us, we are taking the blessed wine in small little plastic cups. After you receive the wine, as you depart down the two sides, you'll take the cups with you, and there are waste bins waiting for you to deposit it there. Our service continues in your bulletin at the top of page 12. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace we were able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy.
Subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross, and he offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the entire world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took a cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is God, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
And we celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
service continues with the post-communion prayer, which is found at the bottom of page 16 in your bulletin. If you would all please stand as you are able. Let us pray. Eternal God,
your Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Life is short. We do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who make this journey with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind, for literally everyone you meet is fighting an unseen battle. And now, my friends, go in peace to follow the good road, and may God's blessings be with you this day and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Our closing hymn is found on page 17 if you would remain standing and join our choir in singing.
Thanks be to God.